Assalamualaikum and good day everyone. My name is Salwa Uthman. I'm from Academy Pengajian Bahasa UTM Shalom. And today, I will be teaching you on how to use AnyDesk application to do remote e-testing for your computer-based listening test. Now, as you can see, I have two devices here. I have my desktop and also my laptop. And my goal for this tutorial is really, really simple. I want to control this desktop, but using this laptop instead. So, let's go ahead and do this. Alright, the first thing that you want to do is you want to go to anydesk.com and download this application from this website. When you run the application that you have installed, this will be the layout that you'll be looking at. Alright, so now I want you to pay attention on the number right over here. This is actually the address number to this particular laptop, and this field right over here is actually a space for you to type in the address of the desktop or probably the device that you want to establish connection to. So in this case, I want to control this desktop using this laptop. Therefore, I'm gonna key in the number of this desktop into the field that I have right over here in my laptop. Let me be very quick to type in the number now, 02, and once I've done that, I'm gonna click connect, right? I'm gonna be waiting for the connection, and I'm just gonna wait for the remote site to accept my session request, right? So right over here, you can also see that there's a request for connection from the other, device. So on this side, gonna click accept, right? So you can see right over here, I get the exact view of this desktop. Now this is what I'm gonna do. If I were to click minimize right over here, you will see whatever that I do here is actually reflected right over here. So I'm gonna minimize this one. See? So I'm gonna close the browser, or probably I'll add another tab to the browser. So I can key in everything and whatnot. But my main goal is not to do that. My main goal is actually to do my CBLT, right? So I'm gonna minimize everything. I'm gonna go find the CBLT file that I have here in the desktop, which I don't have in this laptop. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on it. And I'm gonna click and do it right over here. Wait for a while for it to load. Okay. Now, first thing that I want to do here is that I'm going to key in my lecturer's ID, okay? Okay, for this purpose, I'm just going to type in the sample ID, okay? And click on instructor login, okay? And then go ahead and click here to begin e-testing. Now, here, I want to key in my UITM student ID and then also my IC number. Because I'm not a student, so I'm going to be using a dummy ID. So in your case, you should put your own ID and your own IC number, okay? Alright, click on search my information. For a while, wait to load. Now, if it's all correct, go ahead and click submit to proceed. Read the instruction. You are given 30 minutes to complete listening test, and within the time given, you may revisit, revise, and change your answers. Now go ahead and click on choose listening question.
ELC 1-1.
Alright. Now, this is very important. When you want to answer these questions right over here, there are three parts right over here. For part A, if you want to listen to the audio, you have to click on each of the number right over here. For each of these five questions, yeah. But for part B and part C, these 15 questions right over here, they are based on one long audio. So for number 6 until number 13 is based on audio right over here. So in short, if you want to listen to part B audio, you have to click on this audio icon. If you want to listen to the audio for part C, you have to click here on the audio icon for part C. So let's go ahead. I'm going to do this very quickly.
A team of volunteers spent 185 days. I'm doing some revision.
All right, so I'm done with that. I'm just gonna be, you know, reviewing my answer right over here. I'm gonna click on done, click to submit the test, click yes, and it will bring me to this window. Now, this is very important, yeah? You need to click on the count MCQ scores button right over here. Now, what happens if you don't click on the button? This is what happens. If you don't click on the count MCQ button right over here, your results will not be sent to the server and therefore your marks will not be reflected in the database. Okay, so it's very important for you to click on this button right over here. Click on it, you have counted, generated and saved your total results, and then click OK. And then you will see this button right over here. So go ahead and take a survey before quit. Very quickly, I'm just gonna do this. I'm gonna answer this survey. Okay, so once I've done this, I'm just gonna go ahead and click done and click to submit. Okay, click yes, and then don't forget to send survey responses. Okay, don't forget to click on the button, click okay. All right, so basically I'm done. So I can click the quit button now and I'm out of the system.
Okay, once you have done with your CBLT, what you need to do is you want to break the connection between the two devices. So now I'm just gonna close this window. Okay, now this is how you do it. You are not going to break the connection by clicking on this disconnect button. It will not work because this is actually the view from the other side of the device. Okay, so if you want to connect, if you want to break the connection between this device to this device, you have to control it from here. So I know it's you can easily be confused between this view and also the real view that you have on your, you know, laptop and desktop. So it takes practice, so please bear with me. For this part, what you want to do is that even if you were to close, or if you were to click this, you are not allowed to do that. If you were to close this, nothing happened because you're still in this, you know, device. Okay, what you want to do in order to break the connection is that you need to actually go ahead and click the X button on this particular application, which is, you know, any desk application. So you just go ahead and click here and then you're out from the system. So that's how it is done. Okay, so I hope this tutorial is beneficial for everyone. Good luck.